Hey everyone, it's Sean. If this is your first time checking out my YouTube channel, my name is Sean Berry and I'm a creative professional with over 30 years experience in the business. I'm also partner and creative director of a small boutique agency here in Toronto, Ontario, Canada called Booster Rocket Media, where we do all kinds of cool things like website design, video editing, animation, and graphic design, which of course is what the series is about. And so this is episode number 3 of the beginner series, and we're calling this one the design space. Now, everything that we talk about is going to be related to the design space, but this was this made the most sense to me as a topic and title for today. But you'll see what I mean as we get into it. We're going to talk today about images and how they impact the space. Now, there's no way in one video I can tell you anything useful about images, except that I'm going to give you a way, hopefully, to think about them. And as you design, what kind of considerations an image presents. And that's the best I can do in this one sort of video, but hopefully over several videos and over your career, you'll start to make these decisions and understand them a little bit better. But we're gonna pick up the same layout that we started with in episode 2, and we're gonna continue with that theme because I thought it would make sense to build on that logically. So we're gonna look at images and not just their size and their position, but other things that can affect images and how an image has an effect on your design space and thus on the story that you're trying to tell. So let's just get into it and hopefully we can make some sense out of that. Okay, so here at the desktop, let's jump back into our InDesign file, the same one that we worked with in the last video. Okay, so this is where we left off. This is the actual layout that we had created. Of course, it's not complete, it doesn't have legal copy, and there's a bunch of things that you know, could impact this further, and we'll get to those things. But for today, we're just going to talk about what's happening within the space. So we know we have this headline, and we know we have this visual, and we know that we have this product shot, and we also have this call to action copy at the bottom. So let's start to focus on this image, because this image may, with the elements that we have the largest impact on what happens in the layout, because it has the largest potential for impact. Now, we'll get to typography and messaging a bit later. So this is the layout exactly as it was. And if I go to this next page, you can see that I've taken the image and I've made it smaller. I haven't changed anything else. And by making the image smaller, I've really not accomplished much of anything. I haven't changed the size of the font, obviously, or the package shot. And the photo is in the same position it was in, it's just smaller. So because it's smaller, you can see that it now sort of represents the least important thing in the whole layout. Now, by least important, I mean that I, as a designer, have obviously placed the least importance on the photo by making it the smallest thing on the page. So what does that say about the layout? What does that say about the story that I'm trying to tell, which, again, is really the most important part of all this? We know about the improve your smile and visiting the website to do that, and the little double meaning of improve your smile with the product and with the free sample. But this visual is not necessarily helping any part of that story by just being smaller. Now, of course, if I go the other way and I just make it bigger and I do nothing else, now obviously nobody would look at this as a good layout solution. But I did this to sort of demonstrate a point that this, in fact, is a legitimate way to approach your layout and a legitimate thing to try or a decision to make. And I'll come back to this in a little bit and try and sort through what I mean by that by demonstration if I can. But for now, just accept that this is one option. If one option, the first option rather, is to make the image smaller, the second option is, of course, to make it larger. But size isn't the only story on images. So the other option that I have is to crop the image. Now, I've cropped it down into the center of the page. You can see the border box. Her hair suddenly stops, and her chin and her forehead suddenly stop. And now the image is in somewhat the same place, but it's cropped. And the impact that it has is that you notice the image now is back to its original scale within the layout. However, within the border box itself, she has changed. And I've focused now more directly on her smile. So as I bounce back up to the top, you can see that it's relatively the same amount of visual real estate, but I've cropped it differently, and that changes the emphasis. Now, I'd say that this is maybe an awkward cropping, but just to make the point that if you look at this and you see how this has an effect, you as a designer may try something like this in the process of trying to figure out your page's navigation, but it really does kind of have a strange crop sitting there in the middle. But let's see what we can do with that. So with simply doing one thing, which was to extend the border box all the way out to the edge of the layout, I haven't changed her position within that, just sort of the box itself. And having the strip go all the way across is an interesting design difference. It doesn't affect the image any, and it doesn't affect the message. It just affects the layout in a subtle way. And that is something that is important to think about. Not everything you do is going to help your story specifically, but some of it helps your aesthetic presentation of the story. And that's kind of another important thing for keeping people interested in what they're looking at. It's more subtle than communication, but it's something that can help. So I would say this is a slightly nicer design because this sort of cropped in the middle doesn't really crop with any particular purpose, but this is nice because it goes all the way out to the edge. So it gives you an option. Now, if I use this same photograph, same cropping, but I slightly change her scale and move her down a bit, you can see that cropping really is something that, you know, kind of becomes important. Getting this cropping right helps the image to make sense. Now it just looks like I didn't pay attention, that I didn't know what I was doing when I was cropping the image, that I didn't give it any consideration. And that has an aesthetic effect on your layout. So this being a much better effect, you can see that the type left edges match the left edge of her hair. And the right edge doesn't quite match. It actually breaks out of the border a little bit, but that's okay because on the right side, I also have the package. So I'm kind of playing this game with the left and right sides of this image a bit. And that's subtle, but it's a decision that I made. It was something I was aware of. And this cropping just seems wrong and strange. So these are things you have to think about. On the other hand, if I were to crop this in even a more unusual way, I could make an argument for and against this. The for it is that now we're talking about the smile, like 100%, and it mimics the package. I've used the same cropping of the shot, roughly the same cropping, but you get the idea, that it's similarly focused on her smile, literally. And does that improve your message? Well, it might. I personally think, however, on the downside, it's obviously a strange crop. It's obviously intense. Like it's, you know, I don't understand why I'm this close to her mouth and why am I looking at this and why would this improve my smile? You sort of have to think about those things. But you can see that just the cropping of the image from here to here has an enormous effect. It's a really important element in this space and it's important how we treat it. So now, coming back to that full scale image, if I had decided to try this image at full scale, which if you remember was back here. Now this obviously didn't work, although aesthetically it was an interesting start because she's in the middle and isn't that good? And why wouldn't I want her in the middle? And that's better, and you know, but I can't read the type, so I have this problem. So by jumping here, I had played around with this a little bit, but I solved some problems, but I created others, and I wanted to make you aware that this sometimes happens. If I have a huge image like this, and I now move her over to the right, and I say, okay, isn't that good? You know, because now I've got this nice sort of one-third layout on the left, and two-thirds on the right side is the image, and that's really dramatic. And I can make an argument for it, but I have a few problems now. One problem is that she takes up a lot of the layout, and this type is now kind of getting pushed up and over to the left. But the big problem is this package now faces outside of the layout. The direction is going off the page to the left, which sort of is a balance problem. It's creating a visual strangeness that I'm not entirely happy with. But I could try this, and that would be the point. Now, maybe I'm lucky, and let's say that I had a package shot that was going the other way. So if I just did that for the sake of discussion now, I obviously can't use this because the package is now backwards. But the point I want to make is that if I had this reversed image, that'd be great. But if I don't, and I'm stuck with it going this way, then this solution doesn't work. So even though I found an interesting way to use this full-scale image, this particular way doesn't work because I solved one problem and created two more. Space for the type and the direction of the layout. The package is facing out, and I don't want to face out. I don't want people's attention being dragged off my page. So it's important to understand the consequences of what you try. As we said in the first video, when you introduce new elements into the page or different elements, they have an effect. This is an expression of that problem. I've introduced elements into the layout in a way that don't work together. So if I were to say, what is my version with all these elements that I have that might work properly in this space? then I would suggest that this is it. This is the way that that works. It's a nice cropping of the image. I can see the top of her hair, so it doesn't look like she's gone bald. And I can see her smile, but I don't see much below that. I just kind of am focused. The image is sort of focused in this area of her expression. And it is a pleasant size, a pleasant scale within the layout. I've moved things up and down slightly, but that's because I decided that the height of the image was something I wanted to play with. So I've come all the way, if I just reveal my pages tab here, I've come all the way from this and watch the changes to this. Some of those changes are subtle, but they made a really big difference. And that's because I took the time to play around with the image and decide what exactly its impact should be on the layout. And with all the other elements that have to live together with it, what can I do with these elements as they are to make this work? And this is what I decided does a good job of that. Now I could take this and select free sample, and I could decide, oh, I'm going to try that bold and italic, and I could make it slightly bigger. And so without finessing the type too much, you can see that this has an impact as well. We're going to get to the impact of typography in the next couple of videos. But for now, just know that once you find the right balance of one key element, you can massage the other elements to fit. And so then you begin to build some basic harmony. And building basic harmony is a really important part of this process, is creating a layout that tells a story that makes sense. Now, with that said, the final thing that I'll do is I will take a duplicate of this layout and drop it at the end. So here I have this big image, and let's say that I was really, really drawn to solving this as a problem. Well, just by way of quick demonstration, you can do these things. So let's say that all of that type was possibly medium to give it a little bit more punch. And let's say that I kerned it in a little bit, and I'm going to expand this type block. This is why I hate doing live demonstrations of design. I tried this in some of my earlier YouTube videos, and after just like having the worst day of my life trying to make this all work live, I just gave up. But anyway, you get the idea. So if I have this type and I create a basic relationship between the call to action and the product shot, and I find the right spot for it. And let's say that improve your smile, I'm going to get rid of the big word. And this isn't going to make any visual sense for a moment, but just bear with me. I'm going to put smile at the end. And now I've got these two elements in place with this photograph that, if it wasn't for the photograph, they would kind of make a little more sense. So I could decide to solve this problem by doing a couple of quick things here, which I think this is going too far too fast, but I just want to show you this by way of quick demonstration so that you can see that sometimes when you solve one problem after another, that you can make pretty much any design solution work. Now let's say that this was not solid white, it was maybe, let's say it's 75%, so I can read the type pretty clearly. I'm going to position it a little better in the center, vertical center that is. And of course I've got to bring now the package shot in front of it. And I could actually consider maybe bringing this in a little bit and even bringing that in a little bit. So I've got a solution now for this little bottom banner, but then that would give me a problem with this headline. But that headline is something I could probably solve with a similar technique. But maybe what I'll do in this case is I'll go the other way. Now, I'm not saying that this is a perfect design solution. It certainly is not perfect. In fact, I should just center that a little more. Okay, I'm just going to eyeball it for the purpose of demonstration. But if I wanted to, this doesn't necessarily work, but I think it's close to something that works. And if I had 25 minutes, an hour to play with this, I could make this work if I wanted that big image in the center like this. So this kind of makes sense. It's not perfect, but it makes better sense than, say, something like this. You know, it makes obviously more sense than this, and certainly more sense than something like this. So these are some of the variations that we can play with, and this is kind of what the design process is about. is once we get past the basics, in other words, from where we began, which was a clear layout that clearly communicates, I've gone all the way down to this, which is no less clear, but it is different. I've been able to keep the level of clarity while introducing some new design elements. Now, I can't make an argument, however, that my final version is better than this version. It's only different, but an alternate design. And that's kind of an important thing to understand. Okay, I hope that made some kind of sense. I know that was painful, like watching paint dry, but hopefully you could see from even the wrestling around that I had to do, that sometimes images can be challenging, even if it's a very straightforward image that you wouldn't think would present a lot of design challenge. It kind of can, and there's a deep rabbit hole you dive into when you start playing with cropping, with size, with position, and it all has an impact on what you're doing, and a very important impact. Images are a big deal, and they're a huge part of design. So hopefully that made sense. We're going to talk more in the next upcoming episode about how typography now has an impact on the same space, and how we can build our message with more design and hopefully more effective storytelling elements, which have to do with how all these things work together. So anyway, episode 4 will be coming up in the next week. Hopefully you've enjoyed the series so far, and we're going to keep it rolling. And so until episode number 4, you stay classy as always, and I will see you again soon. Goodbye.